Joe, his name is Joe, your employee's name is Joe. It should be pretty easy to remember. The name of the company is Trader Joe's, and this guy's name is Joe.
John!
I mean, Joe, shit. I've heard great things from your supervisor, Joe. How's the family?
Non-existent, sir.
Hey, that's great.
Have a seat,
Joe.
I think I'll just stand.
Suit yourself.
Well, sir, you're probably wondering why I request this meeting.
Joe, I gotta stop you right there.
Oh, thank you, sir.
No smoke! You got a nickname, Joe?
Not really. Joe's fine.
Nah, Joe's no good. Too hard to remember. I can always remember a nickname. How about Joe Schmo?
Well, I honestly
Average Joe?
I mean, really.
Hey, Joe, where are you going with that gun in your hand?
What?
Jimi Hendrix. There it is. Your new nickname's Jimmy. What can Trader Joe's do for Jimmy?
Well, sir.
Please, Joe, drop the formalities. My father's name is Sir. You can call me Pat.
Oh, okay. Pat.
That's. Mr. Pat. Jimmy, I'm your supervisor. Let's not get too comfortable.
Right, sorry. Okay, Mr. Pat. Well, you see, it's about my performance and my,
Chop, chop, Jimmy, I got a lot of fingers and a lot of pies, and time is money, and money doesn't grow on trees. So, let's get down to brass tacks. What brings you downtown, Duke Jam? What's the score, buddy boy? What can I do for you, Jimmykins?
Mr. Pat, I'd like a raise.
Well, let's see. According to your file, your performance is exemplary.
That's great. I'm glad to hear it.
I'm not. Great is not good. Great is bad. You need challenge in order to rise.
That's exactly how I see it. I think challenges should be rewarded.
In a perfect world, Jimmy, we'd all get a trophy just for participating. But what kind of businessman would I be if I were to keep you on a leash around here?
I'm not asking for much.
A bad one. That's the answer I was looking for. Jimmy, we're headed into sudden death. It's time to ask yourself how you feel in my pants.
What?
The turkey's in your banana, son, but I'm the one punching this donkey. When you run the potato sack race, sometimes you have to fishtail the handlebar mustache. I know it's a hard load to swallow, Tiger. A very sticky situation of a big, chewy load, but turn that in the bunghole, Buster. You gotta eat the worm on this one.
Oh, Mr. Pat, I'm completely lost. A little frightened and... I think you may be hitting on me.
You putting the puppy to sleep, Jimmy?
Oh, I really
put it to sleep, Jimmy.
Good job.
Puppy's gotta go now.
What the hell do you want from me?
Night, night, puppy. Goodbye, Vidgo One.
Go, the poor little puppy!
Jimmy, it pains me to see a man like this. You've been nothing but sincere, and I think you deserve the same. Tell you what, forget about the puppy. Have a seat. You gotta learn to talk shop, Jimmy. That was all just a bunch of euphemistic nonsense. Here, have that cigar. First thing I learned in management, speak in powerful metaphors. Keeps them on their tippy toes. Second thing I learned, name repetition never works. It's a bunch of bullshit, Joe.
It's Joe.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. You're gonna need that kind of wisdom where you're going, kid. Straight to the top!
Mr. Pat! Are you promoting me?
Well, that depends. Would you call a more challenging position with a salary a promotion?
I certainly would. I have, of course, that one uncomfortable question. How much is my raise?
What? A raise? The hell you say?
But you said it was a promotion.
Of responsibility, not money. Well, you're nothing but a traitor. Traitor Joe. That's your new nickname here, Traitor Joe's. Traitor Joe!
Again, Mr. Pet, that seems very confusing.
only confusing to a Brutus of a Judas Iscariot of a Benedict Arnold like you, Traitor Joe. Now get back to work!
But do I still have a job? Did I get the promotion?
Oh, come on, Jimmy. Read between the lines. You're fired. And I sincerely wish you the best. Now give me that shirt. It's company property.
Maybe this is the best thing that ever happened. You'll see. My dad always used to say,
when one door hits you on the ass on the way out, another door opens up and invites your ass inside.
And my ass can fit lots of doors. I'm a man of talent. Heck, one of my favorite parts of the job was throwing little balls of paper in the trash can from across the room. And I'm tall. Why, I could be a professional athlete in the NBA! And I'm adaptable. A survivor. I consider all the possibilities and refuse to be boxed in. I could be an actor, reaching millions of people through a little box. Yeah. And last but not least of all, I'm a man of integrity. A pillar of perseverance. And even if hope fades, and I'm face down in the gutter, even if the odds are insurmountable, you will never hear me say, I quit!
You don't have to quit, because I already fired your sorry son of a... That's coming out of your last paycheck. There's no lawyering here at Trader Joe's, Trader Joe. Now scram!
My ass can fit in lots of doors. Teen has the day off.
Right. Well, the only way to see Mr. Reinsdorf is to make an appointment. You can call the front
desk. Sorry, Miss, what's your name?
Marla.
Thank you, Miss Marla. But I don't have time to make an appointment because I need to sign with the Bulls today. You see, I got fired from my job at Trader Joe's this morning for being too dang good at my job. And seeing as I'm a man of action, a titan of fortitude, oh, an addict of adversity, I knew I had to follow my real calling as Michael Jordan's rightful successor on these Chicago Bulls! And eventually the Toon Squad. So I hopped to Sherry Uber, dropped off Joaquin at the Bean, then Mariah and David at the Field Museum, and Seymour Harry Carey's. Circle back to the Bean because Joaquin forgot his camera and came directly here.
Wow, that's quite the journey. But we don't sign athletes who just walk in off the street. You would need to be represented by an agent who would then negotiate on your behalf with our general manager, Mark.
All formalities. This will only take a minute. Excuse me.
Sir, you need to stop right now. Security, we have a code 76 in room 1023N.
Relax, relax! Once Jerry sees my trash can, Jay, this will all be a funny misunderstanding.
Look, Look, sir, security is on their way. Don't make me call the police as well.
Jerry! It's Joe! I just hit the Jerry! Please!
Okay, is everything all right out here, Marla?
Yes, ma'am. This self-assured gentleman was just leaving. He has no
Jerry? Is that you? You look a lot different than your Google images.
No, I am Wendy Altform Gemschfelde. I am the director of mental health and wellness here. And you are?
The name's Joe. But not Stranger Joe. No, I'm, Air Joe. Dip. Miss Wendy, I am here to repeat the mythical 6 feet for the Bulls. I haven't missed a Dairy Isle hookshot in 3 years. And that was only because a toddler rammed a shopping cart into my tailbone.
Oh, that is very impressive. Joe, and what do you want to play for the Bulls?
Well, MJ has always been a hero of mine, and I've always wanted to fly. Matter of fact, I believe I can fly.
Okay, you're not seriously quoting R. Kelly right now, are you?
Maybe. Why? What's wrong with R. Kelly?
Okay, let's just leave R. Kelly out of this. Aside from looking up to Jordan and wanting to fly, is there any other reason you might have come here today?
I don't know. I guess I really haven't thought that deep into it. But you know, I'd really like to just be out there with the guys. Zach, Nicola, Damar, and the rest of them. Traveling, cracking jokes. Oh, signing babies' heads.
So, you're looking for a team? A family, perhaps?
A family?
Is this a bad job?
That's him, Goron.
Let's go, buddy.
It's for the family, Goron.
Toby! Let's get this V job out of here. Let's go. Chop, chop.
You can fly, Joe. You just gotta find your wings.
That's when I walked right out that door. After I bunched my apron into a ball and threw in my boss's face and left. And then...
No, you did.
You bet I did.
Wow.
And then I stuffed my tiny little ass back inside that door, looked him square in the eye and said...
What? What did you say?
I said...
Go on, tell me. Tell me! Oh, I got it. Well, how are you going to tell me what you said?
Oh, all right. I said... Nothing.
Nothing? Oh, you are such a bad boy.
Am I? No one's ever called me that before.
So, you said nothing. And what next?
Next? How about me and you go out again tomorrow night?
What? No, I meant, what did you say after you said nothing to your boss?
Oh, after I said. I grabbed the hot cigar right out of his mouth, took a long, hard puff, and broke. Wait.
Oh, gosh. Took a long, hard puff and blazed my bony backside right back out that door. Gosh, I knew it started with a B. A bunch of B's, actually. That's great alliteration. This is some good writing.
Can we just get back to the scene?
Sorry. I grabbed a hot cigar right out of his mouth, took a long, hard puff, and blazed my bony backside right back out that door.
You are so bad. Tell me more, stud.
You want more? I'd like to tell you more.
Cut. Oh my gosh, Cut, I cannot do this anymore. Have you never acted on set before?
Well, actually.
No intimacy coordinator means no intimacy, no touching without consent.
But the script says. Script says we sit close as romantic lighting and soft music fill the room.
You know what else should fill the room? Respect. Professionalism.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to. I misread your signals.
Signals? We're acting. This isn't real.
I know that. I just thought you...
Thought you could what? Take advantage of me? Assume I was interested in you? I mean, even if I did think you were cute and charming with that hair and those striking blue eyes. And you know what? No, I am not doing this again. I turned down a very good role for this.
What role?
Zombie number two. It's for an A24 movie.
You turned down a fancy flick to do a student film?
I wanted the speaking lines. Mark my words, keep up your bad, bro-y behavior, and I'll see to it that you never work another collegiate production again. How's that for alliteration?
Welcome back, Jimmy. I'd say I missed you, but it's only been a day and a half. Oh, don't look so down, Jimmy. Tell you what, take a quick 15 out back, get some fresh air in your lungs, along with a little bit of that purple haze, if you know what tune I'm singing, whatever helps you get your head out of the gutter and back into the clouds, Jimmy boy. Here, stick that in your pocket. I won't tell HR.
Thanks. Congratulations! The missus is a lucky lady.
I'm the lucky one.
Yep, it's on the house.
She takes
You really are the people person.
No, I'm the one who's
think someone would argue with that, Joe. Or, should I say, Joe Colomb the Third?
How'd you,
Oh, I did a background check on you when you stopped by yesterday. You know, it looks like you come from a long line of not-so-average Joes. Your grandfather, Joe Sr., was an engineer, and your father, Joe Jr., was none other than Trader Joe himself, owner of this unique grocery store. He left a legacy with the way he treated his employees. He passed that legacy on to his son, Joe the Third.
That's me.
So, why are you ringing people up? Do they even know who you are?
It's home. The people here might be average, but they're like family. Some of them know who I am, but most of them don't care.
Jimmy Cannon! Have you had a new cookie butter bacon burger? It's out of this world! I'm going back for my fifth one now! Speculoon!
Oh, I see your point, Joe.